Here's a quick tip from the Jewelry Workshop.
Hello again and welcome back. I'm Max Goodman here in my studio at Third Ward, getting ready to do some etching. So today I want to talk to you a little bit about the mordant or acid that we're going to use. We're working with copper, and each individual metal has its own sort of corresponding etching acid or mordant, as they're called in the fine arts industry. We are working with this one. This is copper etching mordant, and it is predominantly a chemical called ferric chloride. Anytime that you're working with a new chemical or a new art material and you're concerned about it being hazardous, feel free to Google what's called the MSDS, that's Material Safety Data Sheet. This will tell you all of the safety hazards that could be associated with any particular material. It'll also tell you if you need to wear anything like a respirator or rubber gloves. In the case of ferric chloride, it's good to work in a ventilated area with rubber gloves. Rubber gloves and eye protection if you think you're gonna splash at all. I don't use eye protection. I don't think it's really a big deal for the scale that I'm working, but say you were doing a 2x4 foot etching plate for a printmaking project, it might be important to wear eye protection at that point. If you don't have a ventilated area in your house, simply flip on your stove fume hood or open a window and blow a fan right next to your bath. I personally don't think that the fumes for the ferric chloride are really that big of a deal, but if you're going to repeat the process with nitric acid, which is what you would use for sterling silver, there are some more fumes involved and it may behoove you to actually do this outside. So keep that in mind. Temperature is not a big deal to these mordants. As long as they're not completely frozen, they should function. And the great thing about etching mordants is that you can reuse them again and again until they become exhausted. You'll know that they're exhausted because they'll stop doing anything to the metal. They'll also become very, very opaque. The new etching mordant that I'm going to pour out of this bottle will appear sort of transparent. You can see these etching mordants that I've been using for a while are very, very dark brown and opaque looking, and that tells us that they're beginning to work on the metal and also that they're beginning to become exhausted.
For more great ideas from the Jewelry Workshop, click the link.